Hi all, welcome back. As you can see from the thumbnail, this tutorial is all about how you can calculate percentage and show it in scorecard like this in Google Data Studio. You'll be learning a very simple way to do this and no calculated field is needed. To demonstrate the example today, I'll be using data from my Google Search Console account. So let's get started. Okay, so here I have my data connected to Search Console. You can see I already have a pie chart created to show the percentage of each device type that my audience is using. But what we want to do is to convert this pie chart to three scorecards just like the example here. So first of all, we will need to prepare two scorecards. One is for the total URL clicks, which is the denominator. And the second scorecard is for the desktop URL clicks, which in this case is our numerator. So now I'm going to show you how to do that. First, we are going to click Add a Chart to add a chart, and then select the scorecard. Click on the canvas to add the scorecard. Now, since the random field GDS pick for me is the exact metrics I need, we can proceed to the next step. Otherwise, you just need to drag and drop the field URL clicks into the metrics placeholder. Then we are going to duplicate the chart to create the second scorecard. This can be done in seconds with the shortcut keys. Next, we want to filter URL clicks to only include clicks from desktop device only. To add a filter, go to the Data tab in the Property panel, scroll down, and under the Filter section, click Add a Filter. So here I already have my filter set up. Now I'm going to show you how to do the same. Now at the bottom, click Add a Filter again, and we're going to give a name to the filter. Next, we can configure the rule. Firstly, we can leave the first option as include and select the field as device category. For the operator, we will choose equal to. And lastly, key in the value desktop in the value field. Again, be careful that Data Studio is case sensitive, so you can refer to the values earlier in the pie chart. So just follow that exactly when you fill up the rule settings. Next, we can click Save. Now the scorecard metric is filtered to desktop only. Before we move on, we can also rename the scorecard just to make sure we are clear on the metrics. Here, I'm going to scroll up and click on the Edit icon. In the window, type in the name for the scorecard. Now, this is a very important step. We'll need to merge the two scorecards that we just created to create a separate percentage scorecard. Now, I want you to select the numerator scorecard, then click on Command or Control key on your keyboard, and click on the denominator scorecard. Now that we have selected two scorecards, you can right-click and make sure to select the data blend selection. This would automatically generate a ratio scorecard, which is the percentage of desktop URL clicks over the total. After we have done with the scorecard, let's say if you want to change the display metrics to one decimal only, you can go to Style and under the Primary Metrics section, for the decimal precision, change it from auto to 1. Now we are done with the first percentage card. If you find this useful, please give me a like or comment so that this video can reach more people like you. Back to the tutorial, now you may repeat the same steps above to create all three scorecards like mine, but I want to show you a more efficient way of doing this. First of all, we are going to batch create all the filters we need. Just go to the toolbar above and click Resource, Manage Filters. Look for the filters that we created earlier. Then duplicate the filter for two times. Next, we're going to click Edit to change the values to tablet and mobile. Remember to change the name of the filter as well so we can identify the correct filter later at the chart settings. Once you're done with mobile filter, you can do the same for tablet. Click Save. So now we are back to the dashboard. For the desktop scorecard, we can now remove the filter because I'm going to reuse it to help me create multiple percentage scorecards. Now you can add the new mobile filter at the chart level. Then click Blend Data for these two scorecards. Now switch up the filter again to tablet and create the percentage scorecard using our method earlier. So here's how you can create multiple percentage scorecard fast and quick with this simple workflow. Other than this, sometimes we may also want to highlight the scorecard when we meet a certain KPI or threshold. For example, this scorecard color is automatically switched to green color when the mobile percentage exceeds 5%. For example, when I click Indonesia only, the scorecard background has changed to yellow because of the conditional formatting. If you want to learn how to set up this conditional formatting, this tutorial next will be very helpful for you. Before I end today's video, I will also want to give credits to Nimantha for sharing this percentage scorecard solution, and I'll leave the link to the original post so you may take a look if you wish. Thanks and see you next time. Bye bye!